हेलो एंड अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। स्वागत है आप सभी लोगों का वाई फाई स्टडी स्टूडियोज के इस चैनल पे, इस सेशन पे। सो आज है हमारा डे 5 सेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम अदर क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वी डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन द लास्ट क्लास एंड आई थिंक टुडे इज आवर डे 4 सेशन, राइट? सो वी विल बी डूइंग सम मोर क्वेश्चंस टुडे एंड वी विल बी लर्निंग अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फ्रॉम हियर फ्रॉम दिस सेशन टुडे ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। सो दिस इज योर एजुकेटर ऑफ इंग्लिश आंचल सिंह एंड आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ओवर हियर ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। चलिए शुरू करते हैं। तो सबसे पहले आप सभी को मुझे अन अकेडमी पे जाके फॉलो कर लेना है बाय जस्ट टाइपिंग माय नेम ANCHALSINGH। फॉलो बटन पे हिट करना है। फॉलो बटन पे हिट करने से क्या होगा? फॉलो बटन पे हिट करने से आपको फ्री लाइव सेशंस, फ्री लाइव क्विज, फ्री डाउट क्लियरिंग सेशंस, ये सब कुछ अवेल हो जाएंगी। साथ ही अगर आप पेड कोर्स या प्लस क्लास का हिस्सा बनना चाहते हैं तो आप मेरे कोड का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, AN लाइव कोड का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, 10% इंस्टेंट डिस्काउंट अवेल कर सकते हैं। कैसे आपको यूज करना है मेरा कोड AN लाइव। जैसे ही आप मेरे कोड AN लाइव को का इस्तेमाल करेंगे, आप जो भी प्लान सेलेक्ट करते हैं 1 month, 3 months, 24 months, उसमें फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आप 6500 का प्लान ले रहे हैं विच इज ऑफ 12 months प्लान, आफ्टर सिलेक्टिंग योर गोल्स विच इज बैंक, SSC, एनी वन ऑफ देम, यू विल सी अ डिडक्शन ऑफ ₹650 एंड योर फीस बिकम्स ₹5950 बाय जस्ट यूजिंग माई कोड, राइट? सो इस कोड का इस्तेमाल करना मत भूलिएगा। इससे आपको 10% इंस्टेंट डिस्काउंट मिलेगा। साथ ही इंडिया के बेस्ट एजुकेटर्स आपको पढ़ाएंगे। हर दिन इंटरैक्टिव लाइव क्लासेस होंगी, स्ट्रक्चर कोर्स और PDFs होंगे, लाइव मॉक टेस्ट और क्विज होंगे। ओके, सो दिस इज माई स्केड्यूल, प्लीज हैव अ लुक। 6:30 to 7 AM यू कैन सी मी ऑन वाई फाई स्टडी स्टूडियोज चैनल विच इज टोटली फ्री फॉर ऑल। 10 AM to 11 AM मंडे टू वेडनेसडे आप मेरी क्लासेस देख सकते हैं अन अकेडमी प्लस पे। 11:30 to 1:30 PM आप मेरे साथ जुड़ सकते हैं अन अकेडमी की स्पेशल क्लासेस में विच इज टोटली फ्री फॉर ऑल। 2 PM to 3 PM आप मेरे साथ जुड़ सकते हैं वाई फाई स्टडी बैंक एग्जाम्स चैनल पे। साथ ही 10:30 to 11 AM थर्सडे और फ्राइडे को यू कैन सी मी ऑन वाई फाई स्टडी 2.0 चैनल। ओके, सो इन सभी चैनल पे, इन सभी प्लेटफॉर्म पे आप मेरे साथ जुड़े रह सकते हैं। लास्ट सेशन में हम कुछ क्वेश्चंस कर रहे थे, पैराग्राफ कर रहे थे, रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन कर रहे थे और उसके कुछ क्वेश्चंस बाकी रह गए थे। तो चलिए उस क्वेश्चन को कंप्लीट करते हैं। तो सबसे पहले एक बार फिर से पैराग्राफ रीड कर लिया जाए। मैनेजमेंट इज अ सेट ऑफ प्रोसेसेस दैट कैन कीप अ कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सिस्टम ऑफ पीपल एंड टेक्नोलॉजी रनिंग स्मूथली। द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट इंक्लूडिंग प्लानिंग, बजटिंग, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, स्टाफिंग, कंट्रोलिंग एंड प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग। Leadership is a set of processes that creates organizations in the first place and or adapts them to significantly changing circumstances. Leadership defines what the future should look like, comma, aligns people with that vision and inspires them to make it happen despite its obstacle. So, ध्यान दीजिएगा, leadership क्या कर सकता है या leadership से क्या होता है, right? The distinction is absolutely crucial for our purposes here. Successful transformation is 70 to 90% leadership and only 10 to 30% management. Yet for historical reasons, many organizations today have much leadership and almost everyone thinks about the problems here as one of the managing problems. Yet for historical reasons, many organizations today don't have much leadership and almost everyone thinks about the problems here as one of the managing. For most of this century, as we created thousands and thousands of large organizations for the first time in human history, we didn't have enough good managers to keep all those bureaucracies functioning. So many companies and universities developed management programs and hundreds and thousands of people were encouraged to learn management on the job. And they did, but even more, but people were taught little about leadership. To some degree, management was emphasized because it's easier to teach than leadership. But even more so, management was the main item on the 20th century agenda because that's what was needed. For every entrepreneur or business builder who was a leader, we needed hundreds of managers to run their ever-growing enterprises. Unfortunately for us today, this emphasis on management has often been institutionalized in corporate cultures that discourage employees from learning how to lead. Ironically, past success is usually the key ingredient in producing this outcome. So please read this paragraph up and then I shall show you the second slide and the second paragraph of the comprehension and then we shall further move towards the questions attached to the paragraph. आई होप आप लोगों ने चैनल को लाइक शेयर सब्सक्राइब तो कर ही लिया होगा, सेशन को भी ढेर सारा लाइक कीजिएगा और अनअकैडमी पे आप जाके मुझे फॉलो कर सकते हैं बाय जस्ट टाइपिंग माय नेम ENCHALSINGH फॉर फ्री क्लासेस। चलिए मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। आई होप ये स्लाइड आप लोगों ने पढ़ लिया होगा। नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द पैसेज इज द सिंड्रोम एज आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड इट ऑन मेनी ओकेजंस गोज लाइक दिस। सक्सेस क्रिएट्स सम डिग्री ऑफ मार्केट डोमिनेंस व्हिच इन टर्न प्रोड्यूसेस मच ग्रोथ आफ्टर अ व्हाइल कीपिंग द एवर लार्जर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अंडर कंट्रोल बिकम्स द प्राइमरी चैलेंज। सो अटेंशन टर्न्स इनवर्ड एंड मैनेजेरियल कॉम्पिटेंसीज आर नर्चर्ड विद अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एम्फेसिस ऑन मैनेजमेंट बट नॉट ऑन लीडरशिप। Bureaucracy and an inward focus take over, but with continued success, the result mostly of market dominance, the problem often goes unaddressed and an unhealthy arrogance begins to evolve. All of these characteristics then make any transformation effort much more difficult. Arrogant managers can over-evaluate their current performance and competitive position, listen poorly and learn slowly. Inwardly focused employees can have difficulty seeing the very forces that present threats and opportunities. Bureaucratic cultures can smother those who want to respond to shifting conditions, and the lack of leadership leaves no force inside these organizations to break out of the morass. Please read the paragraph and then we shall move towards the question and answers. Okay, I hope we are done with the passage. So let's move to the question. In the passage, the question here is, in the passage, management is equated with organization, leadership, organization vision, bureaucracy, or managerial training. What will be the correct answer of the following question? Comment box pe aap comment karke mujhe answer bata sakte hain. What should be the correct answer of the following question? Definitely management equals to bureaucracy, isn't it? So this will be the correct answer of the following question. I hope aap logon ne bhi yahi conclude kiya hai passage se. Why companies and universities develops programs to prepare managers in such a large number. Companies and universities wanted to generate funds through these programs. The large number of organizations were created and they needed the managers in good number. Organizations did not want to spend their scarce resources in training managers. Organizations wanted to create communication networks through the trained managers. Which out of the following options will be the correct answer to this question? What will be the correct answer to the following question given in the passage? Why companies and universities develop programs to prepare managers in such a large number? The number of organizations, the large number of organizations were created and they needed the managers in good numbers. This is the correct answer of the following question given over here in this passage, according to the passage. Okay, which of the following characteristics helps organization in their transformation efforts? Emphasis on leaderships but not management, a strong and dogmatic culture, bureaucratic and inward-looking approach, failing to acknowledge the value of customers and shareholders. None of these. Which out of the following options will be the correct answer to this to the given question? Is it given that what characteristics can help organizations to transform in transformation efforts? Definitely every organization tries to put an effort in to make to be better, to grow, to expand, right? So which out of the following will be the correct answer to the given question? Comment box pe comment karke aap answer bata sakte hain and you can tell me what according to you think is the correct answer to the given question. The correct answer to the following question is option number E. None of these. Next, why were people taught little about leadership in management programs? Teachers were busy in understanding the phenomena of leadership. Enough study material was not developing managers. Focus on these programs was on developing managers. Leadership was considered only a political phenomena. None of these. Which out of the following option is the correct answer to the given question? Which out of the following options will be the correct answer to the given question? The correct answer to the given question is option number C. Focus of these programs was on developing managers. Now, moving on to the next question, read the following given statements and arrange them in order in which they frame meaningful para. Choose the from the five alternatives, one having the correct order of sentences. It was with this invincible spirit that Netaji opposed Wavell's offer. Japan's surrender is not India's surrender, he said. The revolutionary spirit of Netaji was never dampened, even after surrender of Japan. He knew that a war of liberation demanded great spirit, great courage, and patience. Which out of the following options is the correct arrangement of question number 41? You have to give the answer to the following question and you have to rearrange the following. What do you think is the correct answer to the following given question? What will be the correct rearrangement here? What according to you people is the correct order of the following question given over here? चलिए आई विल टेल यू द आंसर. सबसे पहले आएगा सेंटेंस नंबर सी. द रिवॉल्यूशनरी स्पिरिट ऑफ नेताजी वॉज नेवर डैम्पेड इवन आफ्टर सरेंडर ऑफ जापान. देन कम्स बी. जापान सरेंडर इज नॉट इंडिया सरेंडर ही सेड. देन कम्स डी. ही न्यू दैट अ वॉर ऑफ लिबरेशन डिमांडेड ग्रेट स्पिरिट. डी. ग्रेट करेज एंड पेशेंस. इट वॉज विद दिस इनविंसिबल स्पिरिट दैट नेताजी अपोज्ड वेवल्स ऑफर. ए. This is the correct arrangement of the following question. Okay, but all work is not education. In India, a majority of people do hard work and strenuous physical work, but all are not educated. It aims at concrete, objective realization of the ideas and is of great educative value. Work is that activity of man which has definite objective. Which out of the following option is the correct answer to the given question? Which out of the following arrangement do you think is the correct answer for the given question? I'll help you out with this question. The question says, sabse pehle, work is that activity of man which has definite objective, first of all. It aims at concrete and objective realization of ideas and is of great educative value, but all work is not education. In India, a majority of people do hard work, strenuous physical work, but all are not educated. This is the correct arrangement of the following question. Next question, here we go. Hari Prasad Nanda is one such person who worked his way to the top from the start, from the scratch. A few of them has a spark that true adventure and their initiative, dedication and sincerity brought them spectacular results, success, sorry. The partition of India and Pakistan made a number of migrants of India penniless. He rose to become first generation entrepreneur with the second largest complex to his credit. Which out of the following options will be the correct answer and will actually make the correct arrangement? The correct answer to the following question is option number is which of the following? The correct arrangement is C. The partition of India and Pakistan made a number of migrants to India penniless. A few of them has a spark of proved adventure and their initiative, dedication and sincerity brought them spectacular success. Hari Prasad Nanda is one such person who worked his way to the top from the scratch. He rose to become a first generation entrepreneur with the second largest complex to his credit. And the option number D. This is the correct answer of the following question. Next arrangement. They think that India will disintegrate like the Soviet Union or Yugoslavia. What will be the exact shape of India in 2080 and can only be a matter of surmise. On the contrary, the blind patriots foresee a very bright future for India. The prophets of doom say that the future of India is doom. What will be the correct answer of the following question? Which out of the following will be the correct arrangement given over here in this question? Answer the following question. क्या होना चाहिए यहाँ पे आज हमारे session में आपको बताना है what should be the correct arrangement of the following sentences. सबसे पहले आएगा option number B, which says what will be the exact shape of India in 2080 can only be a matter of surmise. The prophets of doom say that the future of India is doomed. They think that India will disintegrate like the Soviet Union or Yugoslavia. And on the contrary, the blind patriots foresee a bright future for India. This is the correct arrangement of the following question. I hope aap logo ke bhi arrangement ekdam same hai. Next question. I wish I had more time so I could visit the old nooks or corners of India. And yet I have not seen many parts of the country we loved so much. Seeks to serve our own country is a little world by itself with an infinite variety and places for us to discover. I have traveled a great deal of this in this country and I have grown in years. Which out of the following options is the correct arrangement given over here in this question? DCBA, DBCA, ADBC, CBDA, CBAD. Definitely dikh raha hai that सबसे पहले तो सेंटेंस नंबर डी आएगा. आई हैव ट्रैवल्ड अ ग्रेट डील इन दिस कंट्री एंड आई हैव ग्रोन इन इयर्स. आवर ओन कंट्री इज अ लिटिल वर्ल्ड बाय इटसेल्फ विद एन इनफिनिट वैरायटी एंड प्लेसेस फॉर अस टू डिस्कवर. एंड येट आई हैव नॉट सीन मेनी पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री वी लव सो मच सीक्स टू सर्व. आई विश आई हैड मोर टाइम सो आई कुड विजिट द ओल्ड नुक्स एंड कॉर्नर्स ऑफ इंडिया. दिस इज द करेक्ट अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस. Next question. Okay, study the following idiomatic expressions and its four possible meanings. Find out the correct meaning. Very good. To catch Tata, to catch a dangerous person, to deal with a person who is more than one's match, to trap a wanted criminal with great difficulty, to live carefully and continuously. Yeah, for none of these. Which out of the following options will be the correct answer for question number 46? To catch Tartar, what will be the correct answer of the following idiom? The correct answer to the following question will be to catch a dangerous person. Next question. In the blues, having many blues, being colorful, being behaved like a lord, melancholy and low-spirited, none of these. The correct answer to the following question is option number D, melancholy and low spirited. Next question, to slow the white feather, to try to be beautiful, to perform a good deed, to show courage before enemy, to be calm and quiet. I think to show the white feather would be the correct idiom, not to slow, right? I think it is to show the white feather. To be calm and quiet, to show courage, to perform in a good deal, to try to be beautiful. The correct answer to the following question will be option number C, to show courage before enemy. एनिमी के सामने करेज दिखाना, ठीक है, बट एक्चुअली करेजियस नहीं होना. सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट टुडेस सेशन. वेरी सून वी विल बी फिनिश दिस मिसेलेनियस सीरीज बाय कंप्लीटिंग ऑल द क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन द सेशन. सो सी यू गाइस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. टिल देन टेक केयर, गुड बाय, हैव अ गुड डे. डू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड ऑल्सो लाइक द सेशन. Have a good day.